Oh, it was all the cast, dream cast. I mean, to have everyone who I wanted say yes and by chance be available and be down for this kind of film was a complete dream. You know, Christian Slater is just an icon. You know, I grew up obsessed with Heathers and True Romance, and I was watching season one of Mr. Robot, and he's so good. So I couldn't believe when he said yes. But it was really fun to work with, you know, actors who are established and new, but I do feel like they all, in this case, you know, all work in the same way, meaning, you know, do tons of research, kind of bring their A game. Everyone was nothing but respectful, even though it's only my second feature. So it was a total dream working with everyone. I'm very lucky.
It must have been so weird, because you came over from Disney.
Yes. Definitely very, yeah, I didn't, I actually saw, you know, when you kind of are making lists of people who you want to play a role, he was on an earlier list that I took him off that list because of the Disney past. I just thought, I assumed there's some Disney contract or something that says you can't do films about gay porn. But yeah, then it was a while later when a producer, Scott, who produced the film, he said actually he was attached to this other queer-themed film that fell through, so I don't know, it's worth just reaching out. So we did, and he loved the script, and we met. You know, and I was very honest with him. I said, this is, even though we're not doing, you know, real sex or full frontal, like a short bus kind of movie, or, you know, Nymphomaniac, the sex scenes, you know, you will be at times fully naked and in compromised situations, stimulated sex. I made it very clear, and I just needed the actor who played that role to, you know, give me the, put me at ease that they're not going to be afraid once we're on set. And I could tell that he was so ready to kind of break free of that Disney mold, that he was going to not be afraid to go there, and he did it. Yeah, it's pretty wild. Yeah, I mean, you know, with every passing year, things will only get easier and better for the gay community and also for, you know, gay film or gay art in general. But, you know, it still is a bit harder to get a film with queer content off the ground, and especially one like this. So for me, the kind of you know, evolution of gay rights up until this point has more so made people involved in the film feel comfortable with it. So in this case, the actors, since they kind of are the ones who really championed the film to get it off the ground. It's the fact that someone like James Franco and Christian Slater, they're not afraid to play these gay characters anymore, whereas in the past, actors would be afraid because they fear that people might think they're gay. And so now actors can you know, take on a role like this and not be afraid of that. And in Franco's case, he can, you know, he's played a lot of gay characters, which to me, it's so progressive, and it sends such a good message that, you know, you shouldn't be afraid to play gay or be perceived as gay or whatever.